by the Alama, Sheikh Muhammad Saleh ibn Uthaymeen, may Allah have mercy upon him. It is entitled, Strive Hard in Worship After Ramadan and Fasting the 6 Days of Shawwal.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
All praises belong to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His help and we seek His forgiveness and we turn to Him in repentance and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our own souls and from the evil of our actions. Whosoever Allah guides, there is none who can misguide him, and whomsoever is misguided, there is no guide for him. And I bear witness that nothing has the right to be worshipped except for Allah alone, without partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and messenger. May the prayer and peace be upon him and upon his family and upon his companions and upon those that follow them in goodness.
أما بعد فيا أيها المسلمون قد كنتم ترتقبون مجيء شهر رمضان، فجاء شهر رمضان ثم خلفتموه وراء ظهوركم، وهكذا كل مستقبل للمرء يرتقبه وينتظره ثم يمر به ويخلفه وراءه حتى يأتيه الموت.
O Muslims, verily you were anticipating the coming of the month of Ramadan. So the month of Ramadan came, and then you left it behind you, so it became something that was behind your backs. And like this is the future of everyone. He anticipates something, he waits for it, then he passes by it, and then he leaves it behind him until death comes to him.
لقد حل بكم شهر رمضان ضيفا كريما، فأودعتموه ما شاء الله من الأعمال، ثم فارقكم شاهدا عليكم أو لكم بما أودعتموه.
O mankind, verily you were visited by the month of Ramadan, and it was a generous guest. So you put forward what Allah willed from deeds. Then the month of Ramadan left you, either as a witness against you or a witness for you, according to what you put forward.
لقد فرح قوم بفراقه لأنهم تخلصوا منه، تخلصوا من الصيام والعبادات التي كانت ثقيلة عليهم، وفرح قوم بتمامه لأنهم تخلصوا به من الذنوب والآثام بما قاموا به فيه من عمل صالح استحقوا به وعد الله بالمغفرة. والفرق بين الفرحين عظيم جدا.
Verily some of the people are happy because the month of Ramadan has ended and they are free from it, and they are free from fasting, and they are free from the worship that was hard upon them. And some of the people are happy because they completed the month of Ramadan, and they are free from the sins and wrongdoings. And because of what they put forward from good deeds, they are from those who deserve the promise of forgiveness from Allah. And the difference between these two types of happiness is extremely great.
أيها المسلمون، إننا قد تولينا صيام رمضان وقيامه على تقصير منا وقصور، ولكننا نسأل الله العفو والمغفرة، نسأل الله تعالى أن يتقبل منا ما عملناه في ذلك الشهر وفي غيره، نسأل الله تعالى أن يتجاوز عن تقصيرنا، نسأل الله تعالى أن نجد ذلك يوم القيامة مدخرا لنا ثوابه عند ربنا.
أو مسلمين، Verily we approach the fasting of Ramadan and the praying in Ramadan in a manner that was insufficient and deficient. But we ask Allah that He pardon us and that He forgive us. And we ask Allah Ta'ala that He accept from us our deeds in this month and other than that month. And we ask Allah Ta'ala that He overlook our deficiencies. And we ask Allah Ta'ala that He allow us to find those deeds on the Day of Judgment waiting for us with a reward from our Lord.
أيها المسلمون إن علامة قبول الحسنة كما قال بعض العلماء أن يعقبها الإنسان بحسنة أخرى فإن الحسنات تتبعها الحسنات.
O Muslims, verily from the signs that the good deeds have been accepted, as some of the ulama say, is that the person follows it up with another good deed, because verily good deeds follow good deeds.
وإن من علامة عدم القبول أن يكون الإنسان منتظرا للفراغ من العبادة حتى يعود إلى السيئات بعدها لأنه يحن إلى السيئات والعبادات ثقيلة عليه.
And from the signs that the deeds have not been accepted is that the person is waiting. They're waiting to be separated from the worship so they can return to the evil deeds after it, because he craves and yearns for the evil deeds and the worship is hard upon him.
فاتقوا الله أيها المسلمون وحافظوا على الأعمال الصالحة في غير رمضان كما حافظتم عليها في رمضان فإن عمل المؤمن لا ينقضي بانقضاء مواسم العمل إن عمل المؤمن عمل دائب لا ينقضي إلا بالموت كما قال الله عز وجل واعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين.
So fear Allah, O Muslims, and protect your righteous actions outside of Ramadan, as you protected them inside of Ramadan. Because verily the actions of the believer does not stop, because the season of action has come to an end. Rather, the action of the believer are actions that are persistent, and they don't stop, except with death. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says, what can be translated from chapter 15, verse number 99, and worship your Lord until that comes to you, that which is certain, meaning death.
وكما قال الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون.
And as Allah Azza wa Jal says in chapter number 3, verse number 102, what can be translated as, O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and do not die except while you are Muslims.
وكما قال الله عز وجل يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه فأتى بالملاقاة بالفاء الدالة على الترتيب والتعقيب وهذا يدل على أن كدح الإنسان إلى ربه متصل إلى الموت.
And as Allah Azza wa Jal says in chapter 84 verse number 6, O man, verily you are returning towards your Lord with your deeds and actions, a sure returning, so you will meet Him with your actions. And here this meeting is preceded with the letter Fa, and this is proof of something coming in order and something pursuing another thing, and this is proof that man's toiling with his deeds to his Lord is connected with death.
فيا أيها المسلمون أكثروا من عبادة الله اتقوا الله عز وجل فإنكم لا تدرون متى يفجأكم الموت كم من إنسان خرج من أهله ولم يرجع إليهم وكم من إنسان نام على فراشه ولم يقم منه وكم من إنسان ذر ثوبه ولم يفك إزراره إلا غاسله.
O you Muslims, increase in your worship of Allah. Fear Allah Azza wa Jal, because verily you don't know when death is going to surprise you. How many people have left from their families and never returned to them? How many people have went to sleep on their beds and never gotten up? How many people have buttoned up their thobes and the only one who unfastened the buttons was the one who was washing their body?
فاتقوا الله عباد الله أيها المسلمون لئن انقضى شهر الصيام وهو موسم عمل فإن زمن العمل ولله الحمد لم ينقطع.
So fear Allah, O slaves of Allah, O Muslims, even if the month of fasting has ended and it is the season of deeds, then verily the time for action, and all praises belong to Allah, the time for actions has not been cut off.
وَلَئِنْ قَضَى صِيَامُ رَمَضَانَ فَإِنَّ الصِّيَامَ لَا يَزَالُ مَشْرُوعًا وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ فَمَنْ صَامَ رَمَضَانَ وَأَتْبَعَهُ بِسِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ مِنْ شَوَّالٍ كَانَ كَصِيَامِ الدَّهْرِ.
And if fasting for the month of Ramadan has ended, then verily fasting does not cease to be something that is prescribed, and all praises belong to Allah. So whoever fasts the month of Ramadan and then follows it up by fasting 6 days of Shawwal, it is as though he has fasted the entire year.
وقد سن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صيام يوم الاثنين والخميس وقال إن الأعمال تعرض فيهما على الله فأحب أن يعرض عملي وأنا صائم.
And the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, has made it his sunnah to fast on Mondays and Thursdays. And he said, verily the deeds are presented to Allah on Mondays and Thursdays. And I love that when my deeds are presented, that I am fasting.
وأوصى صلى الله عليه وسلم أبا هريرة وأبا ذر وأبا الدرداء رضي الله عنهم بصيام 3 أيام من كل شهر وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم صوم 3 أيام من كل شهر صوم الدهر كله.
And the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, he advised Abu Huraira and Abu Dharr and Abu Darda, may Allah be pleased with them all, to fast 3 days of every month. And he said, peace and blessings be upon him, fasting 3 days from every month is like fasting all the time.
وحث صلى الله عليه وسلم على العمل الصالح في 10 ذي الحجة ومنه الصيام. وروي عنه صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه كان لا يدع صيامها وقال في صوم يوم عرفة يكفر 2 سنين ماضية ومستقبلة يعني لغير الحاج أما الحاج فلا يصوم بعرفة.
And the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, incited the people with doing good deeds during the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And from these deeds that he incited with is fasting. As it has been narrated that the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, did not leave off this fast. And he said about fasting on the day of Arafat that it will remove the sins for 2 years, the past year and the coming year. And this is for those people who are not making Hajj. As for the person making Hajj, then he does not fast on Arafat.
وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم أفضل الصيام بعد رمضان شهر الله المحرم وقال في صوم يوم العاشر منه يكفر 1 سنة ماضية.
And the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, said, the best fast after fasting the month of Ramadan is to fast the month of Muharram. And fasting on the 10th day will be an atonement for the previous year.
وقالت عائشة رضي الله عنها ما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يصوم في شهر تعني تطوعا ما كان يصوم في شعبان كان يصومه إلا قليلا بل كان يصومه كله.
And Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, said that the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, did not used to fast in any month. And she meant here, optional fast, as he used to fast in the month of Sha'ban. She said, verily he used to fast most of it. Rather, he used to fast all of it.
وَلَئِنِ انْقَضَى قِيَامُ رَمَضَانِ فإن القيام لا يزال مشروعا كل ليلة من ليالي السنة حتى عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ورغب فيه وقال أفضل الصلاة بعد المكتوبة الصلاة في جوف الليل.
And even if the standing for the night prayer during Ramadan has ended, then verily standing in the night prayer has not ceased to be prescribed every night. Every night during the year, and the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, would incite with this, and he would encourage the people with this by saying, the best prayer after the five daily prayers is prayer in the middle of the night.
وصح عنه صلى الله عليه وسلم أن الله تعالى ينزل إلى السماء الدنيا كل ليلة حين يبقى ثلث الليل الآخر فيقول من يدعوني فأستجيب له من يسألني فأعطيه من يستغفرني فأغفر له.
And it has been authenticated that the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, said that verily Allah Ta'ala descends to the lowest heavens every night when there remains a third of it left. And he says, who is making dua to me so that I may answer his dua? And who is asking me for something so that I may give it to him? And who is seeking my forgiveness so that I may forgive him?
فاتقوا الله عباد الله وبادروا أعماركم بأعمالكم وحققوا أقوالكم بأفعالكم فإن حقيقة عمر الإنسان ما أمضاه في طاعة الله وإن الكيس من دان نفسه أي حاسبها وعمل لما بعد الموت والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله الأماني.
So fear Allah, O slaves of Allah, and take advantage of what remains of your life by doing good deeds, and let your actions confirm your statements, because the reality of a person's lifespan is what he has spent in the obedience of Allah. And the intelligent person checks himself, meaning he takes himself to account, and he does deeds that will be there for him after he has died. And the weak person is the one who his soul follows his desires around, and he only has a wish that Allah will protect him.
أيها المسلمون لقد يسر الله لكم سبل الخيرات وفتح أبوابها ودعاكم لدخولها وبين لكم ثوابها فهذه الصلوات الخمس آكد أركان الإسلام بعد الشهادتين هي خمس في الفعل وخمسون في الميزان من أقامها كانت كفارة له ونجاة يوم القيامة.
Oh Muslims, verily Allah has made easy for you the pathways to various types of good, and he has opened up the doors for good, and he has called you to enter these doors, and he has made clear to you the reward for it. Such is the five daily prayers, which is the most important pillar of Islam after the two testimonies of faith, and they are five in action, but they shall count for 50 on the scale. And whoever establishes the prayers, it shall be an atonement and a safety for him on the Day of Judgment.
شرعها الله لكم وأكملها بالرواتب التابعة لها وهي 12 ركعة أربع قبل الظهر بسلامين وركعتان بعدها وركعتان بعد المغرب وركعتان بعد العشاء وركعتان قبل الفجر من صلاهن بنى الله له بيتا في الجنة.
And Allah has prescribed these prayers for you, and he has completed it by surrounding it by the extra prayers that follow it. So they are 12 rak'ah, 4 before Dhuhr, praying them 2 by 2, and 2 after Dhuhr, 2 rak'ah after Maghrib, and 2 more after Isha, and 2 rak'ah before the Fajr prayer. Whoever prays all these prayers, Allah will build for him a house in paradise.
وهذا الوتر سنة مؤكدة سنه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بقوله وفعله، وقال: من خاف أن لا يقوم من آخر الليل فليوتر أوله، ومن طمع أن يقوم آخره فليوتر آخر الليل، فإن صلاة آخر الليل مشهودة.
And also we have the witr, and it is a strong confirmed sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. It is confirmed by his statements and his actions. So he said, whoever fears that he will not stand up in the last part of the night, then let him make the witr in the first part of the night. And whoever desires to stand up in the last part of the night, then let him make the witr in the last part of the night. Because verily, prayer in the last part of the night is witnessed.
لا ينبغي للإنسان تركه، حتى قال بعض العلماء: إن الوتر واجب يأثم بتركه. وقال الإمام أحمد بن حنبل رحمه الله: من ترك الوتر فهو رجل سوء لا ينبغي أن تقبل له شهادة.
And this is better to pray it at the end of the night. So it is a strong confirmed sunnah. It is not befitting that the person leave it off. Such that some of the scholars said that the witr is obligatory, and the person will be sinning by leaving it off. And Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, whoever leaves off the witr, then he is an evil man, and it's not befitting to accept him as a witness.
وأكثره 11 ركعة، ووقته من صلاة العشاء إلى طلوع الفجر، ومن فاته في الليل قضاه في النهار شفا، فإذا كان عادته أن يوتر بثلاث فنسيه في الليل أو نام عنه صلاه في النهار 4. وفي صحيح مسلم عن عائشة رضي الله عنها أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا غلبه نوم أو وجع عن قيام الليل صلى من النهار 12 ركعة.
And the least amount that one can pray for the witr is 1 rak'ah, and the most that can be prayed is 11 rak'ah. And the time that it can be prayed is from Salatul Isha until the Fajr. And whoever misses praying it during the night can make it up during the day by praying 2 by 2. So if his habit was to pray the witr with 3 rak'ah, and he forgets it during the night, or he oversleeps, then he can pray it in the day by praying 4 rak'ah. Because as it comes in Sahih Muslim from the hadith of Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings are upon him, if he was to oversleep or he was sick, so he could not pray during the night, then he would pray it during the day, making 12 rak'ah, praying 2 by 2.
وهذه الأذكار خلف الصلوات المكتوبة، فقد كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا سلم من الصلاة استغفر 3 وقال: اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام، تباركت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام.
And also we have the remembrance that should be done after the 5 daily salat, because the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings are upon him and his family, when he would make the taslim from the salat, he would seek forgiveness from Allah 3 times, and then he would say, Allahumma anta as-salam wa minka as-salam, tabarakta ya dha jalali wa ikram.
و ومن سبح الله دبر كل صلاة 33 وحمد الله 33 وكبر الله 33 فتلك 99 وقال تمام 100 لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير غفرت خطاياه وإن كانت مثل زبد البحر.
And we also have saying Subhanallah after every salat 33 times, and saying Alhamdulillah 33 times, and saying Allahu Akbar 33 times, and this is 99. And then to complete it for 100 by saying La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Whoever says this shall be forgiven his mistakes, even if they are as great as the foam of the ocean.
وهذا الوضوء للصلوات الخمس ولغيرها من النوافل من الصلوات. من توضأ فأسبغ الوضوء ثم قال أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم اجعلني من التوابين واجعلني من المتطهرين فتحت له أبواب الجنة 8 يدخل من أيها شاء.
And also we have the wudu for the 5 daily prayers and for other than the 5 daily prayers, such as the optional prayers. Whoever makes wudu and perfects his wudu, and then he says, I bear witness that nothing has the right to be worshipped except for Allah alone without partners, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and messenger. O Allah, make me from those people who return to you with tawbah, and make me from those people who are purified. The one who says this, the 8 doors of paradise shall be open for him, and he can enter into any door he wishes.
وهذه النفقات المالية من الزكوات والصدقات والمصروفات على الأهل والأولاد حتى على نفس الإنسان. ما من مؤمن ينفق نفقة يبتغي بها وجه الله إلا أثيب عليها.
And we also have the spending of money from zakat and sadaqah, and the person spending money upon his family and his children, even if he spends money for himself. Whoever is a believer and he spends money seeking the face of Allah, then he shall have a reward for it.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَرْضَى عَنِ الْعَبْدِ يَأْكُلُ الْأَكْلَةَ فَيَحْمَدُهُ عَلَيْهَا وَيَشْرَبُ الشَّرْبَةَ فَيَحْمَدُهُ عَلَيْهَا.
And know that Allah is pleased with the slave that eats food and then praises him for that food, or that drinks drink and then praises him for that drink.
والساعي على الأرملة والمساكين كالمجاهد في سبيل الله أو كالصائم لا يفطر وكالقائم لا يفطر والساعي عليهم هو الذي يسعى بطلب رزقهم ويقوم بحاجتهم والعائلة الصغار والضعفاء الذين لا يستطيعون القيام بأنفسهم هم من المساكين فالسعي عليهم كالجهاد في سبيل الله أو كالصيام الدائم والقيام المستمر.
And also those who look after the needs of the widows and the poor people. He is like the one who fights in Allah's cause, or he is like the one who fasts non-stop and does not break his fast, or he is like the one who stands in prayer and does not slacken up. This is the one who goes out seeking provision for those less fortunate, and he stands up and takes care of their needs from those who are small in number, or those who are weak and are not able to take care of their own affairs, from those who are less fortunate. This person who takes care of their affairs, he is like the one who fights in Allah's cause, or he is like the one who fasts all the time, or he is like the one who prays non-stop.
فيا عباد الله إن طرق الخير كثيرة فأين السالكون وإن أبوابها لمفتوحة فأين الداخلون وإن الحق لواضح لا يزيغ عنه إلا الهالكون. فخذوا عباد الله من كل طاعة بنصيب. فقد قال الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اركعوا واسجدوا واعبدوا ربكم وافعلوا الخير لعلكم تفلحون.
O slaves of Allah, verily the paths to good are many. So where are those who are going to tread these paths? And verily the doors to good are open. So where are those who are going to enter these doors? And verily the truth is crystal clear. No one strays from it except he is destroyed. So take, O slaves of Allah, take a portion from every type of obedience. Because verily Allah Ta'ala says in chapter number 22, verse number 77, what can be translated as, O you who believe, bow down and prostrate yourselves and worship your Lord and do good that you may be successful.
وفقني الله وإياكم لاغتنام الأوقات وإمارتها بالأعمال الصالحات ورزقنا اجتناب الخطايا والسيئات وطهرنا منها بمنه وكرمه إنه واسع الهبات. وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.
May Allah give me and you tawfiq to take advantage of our time and our lifespan by doing righteous deeds. And may Allah give us the ability to stay away from mistakes and sins, and may He purify us from them by His grace and by His blessing. Verily Allah is abundant in bestowing His mercy. And I send peace and blessings upon our Prophet Muhammad, and upon his family, and upon his companions, and upon those that follow them in goodness until the day of judgment.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر وأشكره وقد تأذن بالزيادة لمن شكر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولو كره ذلك من أشرك به وكفر وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد البشر الشافع المشفع في المحشر صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه خير صحب ومعشر وعلى التابعين لهم بإحسان ما بدا الصباح وأنور وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد.
All praise belongs to Allah as we have been ordered, and I thank Him, and the one that thanks Him shall be given an increase, and I bear witness that nothing has the right to be worshipped except for Allah alone without partners, even if those who make partners with Allah hate it. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and messenger, the best of mankind, the one who shall intercede on the day of gathering. May the peace and blessings be upon him and upon his family and upon his companions who were the best of mankind and upon those who follow them in goodness. As to what follows.
بعد يوم العيد وتابعوا بينها هذا آخر يوم لهم وقد ثبت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه بستة أيام من شوال كان كصيام الدهر.
And those who fast 6 days from the month of Shawwal directly after Ramadan, after the Eid, as it has been authenticated that the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings are upon them, said, whoever fasts the month of Ramadan and then follows it up by 6 days of Shawwal, it will be as though he has fasted the entire year.
وذلك لأن الحسنة بعشر أمثالها فصيام رمضان عن عشرة أشهر وصيام الستة عن شهرين فهذه هي السنة كلها.
And this is because the deeds are up to 10 times of their value. So fasting the month of Ramadan is equivalent to 10 months. And fasting 6 days of Shawwal is equivalent to 2 months. And that is the entire year.
وَإِنَّ فِي صِيَامِ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ السِّتَّةِ مَسَائِلْ يَسْأَلُ عَنْهَا النَّاسُ كَثِيرًا فَمِنْهَا هَلْ يُشْتَرَطْ أَنْ يَصُومَهَا الْإِنسَانُ مُتَتَابِعَةً أو هو ينال الأجر وإن صامها متفرقة. والجواب على ذلك أن الإنسان ينال أجرها سواء صامها متتابعة أم متفرقة، ولكن المبادرة بها وصيامها متتابعة أفضل لما فيه من المبادرة إلى الخير.
And this affair about fasting the 6 days of Shawwal, the people have many questions concerning it. From those questions are, is it a condition that the one who fasts these 6 days has to fast them consecutively, or will they receive the reward if they divide the fast up? The answer is that the one who fasts will receive the reward whether he fasts these days back to back or whether he divides them up. But the one who rushes to do this fast and the one who fasts back to back is better, because this one will be rushing to do good.
والسؤال الثاني، هل يجوز للإنسان أن يصومها ثاني يوم العيد أم لا بد أن يتأخر 3 أيام قياسا على أيام التشريق في عيد الأضحى؟ والجواب على ذلك أنه لا بأس أن يصومها من ثاني يوم العيد، بل إن ذلك أفضل، وليس في عيد الفطر أيام تشريق، وإنما أيام التشريق في عيد الأضحى، لأنه هو اليوم الذي تذبح فيه القربان، وهي أيام أكل وشرب وذكر لله عز وجل.
The second question is it permissible for the person to begin fasting these 6 days of Shawwal the day after the Eid, or does he have to wait for 3 days like is done on Eid al-Adha? And the answer is, it's no problem if the person begins to fast the 6 days of Shawwal the day after the Eid. Rather, it is better, because Eid al-Fitr does not have the 3 days after the Eid like we find in Eid al-Adha, because on Eid al-Adha the people are slaughtering the sacrifice. So these 3 days afterwards are for eating, drinking, and making dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal.
السؤال الثالث، هل ينال الإنسان أجر هذه الأيام الستة إذا صامها قبل أن يقضي ما عليه من رمضان؟ والجواب أنه لا ينال أجرها، لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه بستة أيام من شوال، فقال: من صام رمضان، ومن كان عليه قضاء فإنه لم يصم رمضان بعد، بل بقي عليه الأيام الباقية. وعلى هذا فلا ينال الإنسان أجرها إلا إذا أتم رمضان كله ثم صامها بعد ذلك في شوال.
The third question is, will the person receive the reward for fasting the 6 days of Shawwal if they fast these 6 days before they make up the days they missed in Ramadan? The answer is, the person will not receive the reward, because the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, said, whoever fasts the month of Ramadan and then follows it up by 6 days of Shawwal. So he said, whoever fasts the month of Ramadan. So whoever has days to make up, then he has not yet fasted the month of Ramadan. Rather, he has days left to make up. So upon this, the person will not receive the reward until after he has made up all the days from Ramadan, and then after this he fasts the days for Shawwal.
يقول بعض الناس: إن الإنسان إذا صام هذه الأيام الستة في سنة فإنه يجب عليه أن يصومها كل سنة. والجواب على ذلك أن هذا ليس بصحيح، فإن صيام هذه الأيام نفل وتطوع، إذا صامه الإنسان في سنة أدرك أجره، وإذا تركه في سنة لم يدرك أجره، ولكنه لا يأثم بذلك، لأن النوافل لا يأثم الإنسان بتركها، ولكن ينبغي للإنسان إذا عمل شيئا من العبادات أن يثبته ويديم عليه، كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أحب الأعمال إلى الله أدومه وإن قل.
The fourth question is, some of the people say that if the person fasts the 6 days from Shawwal this year, then it becomes obligatory upon him to fast the 6 days of Shawwal every year. The answer to this is not correct, because fasting these days is optional. So if the person fasts 1 year, he shall receive the reward. If he leaves it off another year, then he shall not receive the reward, but he shall not be held accountable for this. Because the optional actions, the person does not become a sinner if he leaves them off. But it is not befitting, except that the person does actions from worship, and he is firm upon them, and he does them on a continuous basis. As the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, said, "The most beloved deeds to Allah are those that are done continuously, even if they are a little bit."
أيها المسلمون، إن بعض الناس يعتقدون أن اليوم الثامن من هذا الشهر، أعني شهر شوال، يوم عيد، ويسمونه عيد الأبرار، وهذا ليس بصحيح، بل هذا اليوم الثامن من شوال كاليوم السابع والتاسع منه، لا فرق بين أيام شوال في هذا.
Oh Muslims, some of the people believe that the eighth day of this month, I mean the month of Shawwal, is another Eid, and they call it the Eid of the Righteous. This is not correct. Rather, this eighth day of Shawwal is just like the seventh day of Shawwal and the ninth day of Shawwal. There is no difference between these days at all.
حتى إن بعض الناس يسأل يقول: هل يجوز أن أصوم اليوم الثامن لأنه عيد الأبرار؟ فنقول: إنه ليس بعيد، ولا يحدث فيه شيء من شعائر العيد، لا يترك صومه، ولا يحدث فيه أطعمة ولا صدقات ولا غيرها، لأنه كسائر الأيام.
And some of the people even ask, they say, is it permissible to fast on the eighth day of Shawwal because it is the Eid of the Righteous? We say, it is not the Eid of the Righteous, and this day does not have any of the rites of the Eid. Nor should fasting be left off during this day, nor is it prescribed to feed anyone, nor to give sadaqah, especially for this day, because it is like all the rest of the days.
فاتقوا الله عباد الله وتفقهوا في دينكم وخذوا دينكم من كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن طريق أهل العلم الذين عرفوا بالعلم والنصح لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم.
So fear Allah, O slaves of Allah, and gain an understanding of your deen, and take your deen from the book of Allah and from the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings are upon him, upon the path of the people of knowledge, those people who are known for their knowledge, and they are known for having sincerity for Allah and his book and his messenger, and for the leader of the Muslims, and for the common folk from amongst the Muslims.
وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ خَيْرَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ وَخَيْرَ الْهَدْيِ هَدْيُ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَشَرَّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا وَكُلُّ مُحْدَثَةٍ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ بِدْعَةٌ وَكُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٌ وَكُلُّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِالْجَمَاعَةِ فَإِنَّ يَدَ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْجَمَاعَةِ وَمَنْ شَذَّ شَذَّ فِي النَّارِ واعلموا أن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه فقال جل من قائل عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد.
And know that the best of speech is the book of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. And the worst of all affairs are newly invented matters, for every newly invented matter in the deen of Allah is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is going astray, and every astray is in the hellfire. And upon you is to be with the jama'ah, because verily the hand of Allah is over the jama'ah, and whoever separates himself shall be separated in the fire. And know that Allah has given you a command in which He began with Himself. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, chapter number 33, verse number 56, what can be translated as, verily Allah and His angels send prayer and peace upon the Prophet. O you who believe, send upon him prayer and peace. O Allah, send prayer and peace upon your slave and upon your messenger, Muhammad.
اللهم ارزقنا محبته واتباعه ظاهرا وباطنا، اللهم توفنا على ملته، اللهم احشرنا في زمرته، اللهم اسقنا من حوضه، اللهم ادخلنا في شفاعته، اللهم اجمعنا به في جنات النعيم برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين.
O Allah, give us love for him, make us of those who follow him, and that which is apparent and that which is hidden. O Allah, take our souls while we are upon his way. O Allah, gather us in His gathering. O Allah, give us drink from His pond. O Allah, make us of those who he can intercede for. O Allah, gather us with Him in the paradise by Your mercy, Ya Arhamar Rahimin.
Allahumma aslih lil muslimin wulata umurihim. Allahumma aslih lil muslimin wulata umurihim. اللهم أصلح للمسلمين ولاة أمورهم صغيرهم وكبيرهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم أصلح لولاة أمور المسلمين بطانتهم. اللهم أصلح لهم البطانة وأعنهم على أداء الأمانة.
O Allah, rectify for the Muslims their leaders. O Allah, rectify for the Muslims their leaders. O Allah, rectify for the Muslims their leaders. Those small leaders and those major leaders, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. O Allah, rectify for the Muslim leaders a good entourage. O Allah, rectify for them a good entourage that will help them and assist them upon filling the trust.
Allahumma man kana min bitanatihim nasihan lahum wa li ra'iyatihim fathabbithu ala dhalik wa man kana ala siwa hadha fa'ab'idhu anhum وأبدلهم بخير منه يا رب العالمين إنك على كل شيء قدير.
O Allah, whoever amongst them has a good entourage that are giving them good advice and that are helping them out in their leadership, then make them firm with them. And whoever has other than that, then separate them from them and replace them with better than them. Ya رب العالمين, verily you have power over all things.
اللهم أصلح شعوب المسلمين، اللهم أصلح شعوب المسلمين، شبابهم وكهولهم وشيوخهم، ذكورهم وإناثهم يا رب العالمين، إنك على كل شيء قدير.
O Allah, rectify the Muslim societies. O Allah, rectify the Muslim societies. The youth, the middle-aged, and the elderly, the male and the female, يا رب العالمين, verily you have power over all things.
اللهم انصر المجاهدين في سبيلك في أقطار الدنيا كلها يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن معهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم أيدهم بنصرك. اللهم ثبت أقدامهم. اللهم انصرهم على القوم الكافرين يا رب العالمين. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأوفوا بعهد الله إذا عاهدتم ولا تنقضوا الأيمان بعد توكيدها وقد جعلتم الله عليكم كفيلا إن الله يعلم ما تفعلون. واذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
O Allah, help those who strive in your cause, in every part of the earth, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Allah be with them and do not be against them, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Allah assist them with your help and make their feet firm. Allah help them upon the disbelieving folk, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Allah forgive us for our sins and help us in our affairs and make our feet firm and help us against the disbelieving folk. Allah forgive us and our brothers that preceded us in faith and do not put anything in our hearts for those that believe. O our Lord, verily you are the most kind, the most merciful. O slaves of Allah, Allah orders you with being just and being good and giving their rights to the kinfolk, and he forbids you from evil and wickedness and from transgression, and he warns you so that you may take heed. Fulfill your trust with Allah when you have been entrusted, and do not invalidate your faith after you have affirmed it. Verily Allah has placed a guarding over you, and Allah knows all that you do. Remember Allah, the